Most of us know that surrounding ourselves with successful people makes us that much more likely to become successful ourselves. Having mentors teaching their skills, their philosophies, and mentalities can completely change your life forever. But a question that keeps popping up is, how do I get mentors? So today I'm going to show you step by step how you can get rich and successful people to become your mentors. If you like videos about business, money, and psychology, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button to not miss any of our value-packed videos. And let's get started. Before you start looking for mentors, first, and this is important, we must get clear on what you're looking to accomplish. Because if you get amazing mentors with great information when you don't have a clear objective, you might end up with a lot of good information, but with no clear destination in mind. It's like getting a car and not knowing where you're going. First, we must get clear on what you're looking for. This way, you are prepared to be efficient and effective and take full advantage of a mentorship. So let's get clear on your goals. Think about what you want to accomplish. Let's start with what you want to accomplish in the next 5 years. I highly recommend you write this down. Once you write your goals down, look at your list and circle one or two things that are the most important to you. Those are the things that you want to focus on and not be distracted by the rest. Once you have your end goal, what you want to accomplish, let's reverse engineer what it would take to get there. Ask yourself, what are all the skills I need in order to accomplish this goal, and write those down. Now, there's one more step. Ask yourself this question. If you could learn only 3 skills in order to achieve this goal, what would they be? The last step makes sure that you don't get overwhelmed with all the options and focus only on the most important skills. This will create clarity on what you need to learn from a mentor. And now you are ready to be mentored. The first thing I recommend anyone looking for mentors do is to start by reading books. Now that you have clarity on what you need, you can start reading books on that specific skill that you want to develop. There are amazing people who've compressed years of knowledge and experiences into a book. There are books in just about any area that you are interested in. There are business books, investing books, psychology books, graphic design, music. Chances are there are books out there with great information about the topic you are looking for. Many people underestimate books because they are widely available to everybody. But if the average CEO reads around 50 books per year, it gives us a great indication of how important reading can be as a mentorship tool. If even the most successful people in the world read books, you might want to follow their footsteps. Now, the beauty of the modern internet is that we have amazing resources available to us for free. YouTube is a great platform where you can find information about almost any topic. You can find videos from tutorials, speeches, and all the different types of informational videos for free online. These are some of the things I recommend first because they require little to no monetary investment. If you don't have the money to spend, you can go to the library and read books or go online and find good, free resources. If you have the cash, you can buy courses from experts in your craft. If there is someone who is doing what you want to do and they happen to compile their information and experiences they had into an informational course, you can save time researching on your own and purchase a course. Saves you time and you might be able to build a relationship with those mentors. Now, these are the things I recommend you start with. You can get amazing information and learn at your own pace. I typically recommend starting seeking one-on-one mentorships after you already have some knowledge about your topic. If you go to an expert in your field with no knowledge, chances are they'll send you back to learn the basics and come back to talk to them. But if you're ready to have a mentor, here are a few things you can do. Number one, you can go local. In every city, there are countless businesses who are successful and have been successful for years. Chances are these business owners are quite experienced at some of the skills that you want to learn and could be a great option for mentorship. There are a few ways you can go about getting these local entrepreneurs as mentors. First, you can find something that you can do to help these entrepreneurs' businesses thrive. It could be things from social media management, website design, logo design, content creation like photography or video for their social media and websites, or many other things. No business is perfect, and if you can find a gap where you can add value, that can be your way in. there are a couple of ways you can go about getting close to these entrepreneurs. One way is to write a good old letter saying how you enjoy their business. You can mention how you might be able to help and bring value to their business. At the end, make sure you let them know that you are more than happy to help them for free, since you are just a new entrepreneur looking for great mentors who you can learn a thing or two from. You'll be surprised how many business owners respond to your messages. Local entrepreneurs typically don't get asked to be mentors, especially by someone bringing value to their business. By doing this, you can make these entrepreneurs feel praised and important. The truth is that many entrepreneurs don't have many people knocking down their door looking to learn from them, and in many cases, the entrepreneur life can be a little lonely. So by doing this, you might hit a very important psychological need, the need for significance. They might become flattered by you seeking mentorship from them. Personally, I feel flattered when someone seeks mentorship from me. I recently gave away around 30 plus coaching calls to many of you guys looking to start a profitable YouTube channel. Coaching calls with me cost a few hundred dollars per session, and I don't do them very often because they're not very scalable, but because I am very grateful for you guys watching and taking action, I hop on the phone with you guys every once in a while. And it all comes down to the feeling of being significant. So you can use that psychological trigger to find mentors. Another great way to find local mentors is to go to your local chamber of commerce. That is where local businesses gather to discuss business, local politics, policies, among other things. There, you can create great relationships with other entrepreneurs without doing all the work from the last step. Just about every city has them, and I believe that you can go there for free at least a couple of times before you start paying for a membership. Now that is finding local mentors. If you are looking for mentors outside of your zip code, there are a few ways that I found to be very effective in finding extremely successful people to give you advice. One of them is to attend networking events, seminars, and masterminds. You'll be surprised how many successful people attend these events. And not just as speakers and coaches, but as audience members. About 90% of all millionaires that I've ever met, I've met in seminars and mentoring retreats like these. Some of them are speakers and coaches, but many of them are in the audience. This is another great way to use the psychological need for significance, because if you find great entrepreneurs in the audience, chances are, even if they're just as successful as the speaker, they might feel a stronger need to feel significant because they're not getting as much attention as the speaker. And since those environments are highly encouraging for socializing and networking, it makes it very easy to build relationships with incredibly successful people. You'll find that most of the successful entrepreneurs who attend these events are extremely humble and more than happy to help. Another quick way to get someone to give you advice and mentor you is to offer to pay for a phone call. By doing this, you show the mentor that, first of all, you are invested in learning from them, and second, that you respect and value their time because you're willing to pay for it. Chances are that they will be more than happy to hop on a quick phone call with you for very little because they feel flattered that you offered. I've met very successful entrepreneurs who are happy to hop on a 20-minute phone call with people who've asked. Now, successful people have very busy schedules, and if a lot of people are asking, you might have to pay a little more for mentors to consider taking your phone calls. Now, there is something important that I want to mention here. Do not ask for a coaching call for free. This could be quite offensive to many entrepreneurs because this insinuates that you don't value their time, and your time is more valuable than theirs. Same goes with their informational programs. I've met many entrepreneurs who have banned people from ever being part of their business because they asked for free stuff. If you don't have the money, then do the same thing you did to buy the phone you're holding right now. Save the money. Now, if you absolutely do not have the money, there are a few ways that you can get a free coaching call with successful entrepreneurs. This is not a guarantee, but hey, it's free. Due to the beauty of the internet, many entrepreneurs hold podcasts, YouTube shows, and live streams where you can get a chance to get on a phone call with these entrepreneurs. Now, if you're going to get on a phone call, or any coaching call for that matter, make sure to be prepared. Have your questions ready to not waste any time or even the opportunity to make the most of the call. I've personally made those mistakes myself, so out of experience, do not make that mistake. You don't want your time, money, and opportunity to go to waste. So, be prepared. Now, something that is very important here is that having mentorship is not what most people think. Many people think that having mentorship means having a classroom and having someone there guiding you all the time. If you want a successful entrepreneur to coach you, you must understand that they are very busy and they have absolutely no need or obligation to mentor you, and you will carry 100% of the workload. Your success is not dependent on them, it's dependent on you. Mentorship could be a simple 15-minute conversation. I've personally had mentors who've completely changed my life, even though I only spend 10 minutes with them. I've had mentors who've changed my life who I've never met. Here is the truth. A mentor cannot help you unless you are ready to take immediate action on what they advise. Information is just information, and a mentor can only help you when you are ready to be mentored. And I will see you in the next video.